So good morning students, today we will understand that how we have been motivated for these artificial neural networks. So artificial neural network, this is a very important area, and artificial neural network has been derived from its counterpart, that is biological neural network, that we normally study in biology, or we can say our human brain. So whatever the capabilities and usefulness we have in our brain, so the concept of those concepts which we have in our human brain are derived in an area, that area is known as artificial neural network. So let us see. So artificial neural networks, or in short they are also known as ANNs, have been derived from biological neural networks. It is a network of massively parallel tiny processors. Billions of processors are there, or we can say billions of neurons are there in our human brain, and these small neurons are known as tiny processors, or these are the biological neurons in the human brain. The structural constituents of human brain are neurons. They are connected in such a complex way which is not known yet. So these neurons are connected in such a way which is really very complex. It is very complex to understand, but it is very simple. Our brain is very simple, its working is very simple. We just receive the input, and after some processing it gets some output. So that we will see later. So human brain can be considered as a highly complex non-linear and parallel computer, like in this figure. This is a very basic figure, we can say. So now different parts of human brain are responsible for processing different pieces of information, and these parts of the brain are arranged in hierarchy or in layers. So in our biological brain, we can say there are so many parts, and each part is responsible for processing different kind of information. As information enters or comes into the brain, each level of neurons process the information, provides insight, and passes the information to the next more senior layer. So this is the normal procedure of the brain. Now let us consider an example. The brain may process the delicious smell of pizza from a restaurant in multiple stages. Let us consider this is a kind of input for our brain. Smell of pizza from a restaurant in multiple stages. So now we can see, we can analyze these stages. Stage 1, let us say this is A. I smell a pizza, or I smell pizza. That's your data input. This is your data input. Then B, stage B. I love pizza. This is a thought, this may be a thought. Next stage is I am going to get me some of that pizza. This is decision making. So I am going to get some of that pizza. This is decision making. It means we are making some decision, our brain is making some decision. Next stage is, oh, but I promised to cut out junk food. This is our memory. On the basis of the memory, we decide something. So like this, I promise to cut out junk food. That is to say, our memory says that we are not going to take any junk food now. But in the next step, next stage, surely one slice would not hurt. So this is the reasoning. It means if we suppose we take one slice, it is not going to hurt our body. So this is a kind of reasoning, and then I am doing it. So this is the action. So we can say the brain may process the delicious smell of pizza from a restaurant in multiple stages. So this is the processing at the multiple levels. So we can say this is also the motivation for the neural network. Now let us consider a very familiar task of face recognition of a person who is known to us and to whom we met 10 or 20 or more years ago. When thousands of persons had been around us, then how we recognize him or her face instantly in the mob. So in a crowd, somewhere this may be a crowd, this may be a mob. So this, he may be your friend and you are going to meet him after 10 or 20 years. So let us say this is the task, and this task is the same task is being given to a human being and to a computer. Now let us see how human being and a computer will solve this or identify the image, the face of that person. Now let us see the analysis. We know the person, but a computer doesn't know. Computer needs a database of images of thousands of persons who had been around us during this period. Means if we are going to give this task to a computer, computer will require a database, and this database of images of thousands of persons who had been around us during this period. The computation time of computer could be hours or days, or it may depend on the database of images. If this database is of 20 years, then it may also increase. So computer recognition directly depends on the database. If this database is large, it will increase the time. Ultimately, what is going to happen? It will give result and tell about the person which best resembles. So this computer will result ultimately on the basis of the database it is having in its memory, that or which best resembles. Now the question arises, how human recognize the person instantly while a computer doesn't? We may think about the processing speed, because we are the engineers, we are the computer professionals, so we may think about the processing speed. Now let us analyze it. The response time of a typical IC is 1 nanosecond, and the response time of human computation is 1 millisecond. This is 6 order less than a computer's computation time. So we can see from here, the response time of a neuron is 1 millisecond, but the response time of one IC is 1 nanosecond. It means the computer must recognize earlier than a human being. But it is not going to happen. We are recognizing a person earlier or in very less time in comparison to a computer. So how the neural processing in brain is much faster than computer in recognizing the things? For example, face of person to whom we met 10 years back. Now the answer is, the network of neurons in human brain are massively parallel. Nerve cells or neurons are 10 billion and 60 trillion interconnections. So we can say the answer lies in this. These neurons, 10 billion neurons, are arranged in our brain in a parallel fashion, or we can say these neurons are massively parallel, or they act in a parallel manner. So the answer of the question that we instantly recognize the face of a person to whom we met 10 years ago or 20 years ago on the basis of his face, on the basis of sometimes his voice or her voice. So the answer lies in the massive parallel structure. So basically all the neurons in our brain, they are arranged in a parallel fashion, they act in a parallel way. So this answer lies in this massively parallel structure. Now the question arises, is it possible to develop a computer which contains such massive processors which could act similar to human brain in a parallel manner? Answer is no. We cannot develop a computer, we cannot make a computer which would have massive processors, which contains such massive processors or millions of processors. It is not possible. But it is possible to make a network which could mimic the behavior of human brain up to some extent, which would be very, very small part, which would be very, very small part of it, containing few artificial neurons. So we can say ultimately that we can create a small computer that will have the features, that will have the concept of biological neuron, biological neural network. So from this concept we have been motivated. So we normally take the feature of human brain and we make some small programs or small computers that could mimic the its counterpart, that is biological neural network. So this is the motivation. So thank you. I hope that you would be benefited from this video of motivation to neural network.